Hey traders, Raghee here, and in this free video, we're going to talk about something we haven't discussed in a little bit, and that is the grains, actually specifically corn and beans. Now, the story around corn and beans is weather related, as many things are at this time of year when it comes to grains. And the story is what? The weather has prevented a large acreage of corn from being planted. I mean, you have pictures of equipment stuck in the mud. You have images of literally just waterlogged fields that look like lakes. It's really been a very trying planting season. Well, that just means less corn has been put in the ground, and that means that as we see this move higher in corn, I don't think it's done yet. So where is it going and where is our entry? Now, keep in mind the backdrop of this trade is that we are going to get what is expected to be, and it's not completely discounted yet, but the discussion has begun, what is expected to be a harvest that's going to miss, right? So now what are we talking about? Pure supply and demand, right? We don't know the demand story, but don't underestimate some sort of agreement between the U.S. and China. Ags are certainly in the conversation there. They have been even for U.S., Mexico. And of course, if there is a demand story on top of this reduced supply story, it's tough to want to bet against corn. But the problem is you don't want to buy at the high of the range. So let's get tactical for a moment. This is not the zone you want to buy in. It's the pullback. It's the pullback. And so the other question is, well, how do we know if we're in a buy the dip type environment? That's where I'll rely on the key sort of the clues and key in on the grab candles. Consistently green grab candles, nice upward trend, plenty of propulsion dots at the 13 EMA, 21 EMA, 55 EMA, so plenty of levels to want to consider for pullback buys. We tend to be bouncing off the 13 EMA right now. I think that's a good place to put in a little bit of your position, really no more than half. The other half would be waiting between the 21 EMA and the 34 on the high. And really that 21 EMA would be a great level. The 21, the green dots here, waiting at about 437 and a half. That would be a great place to build a pretty decent sized position, keeping in mind we could get down to 431. So this is what you want to keep in mind. At the first level, build a smaller position, maybe a third or even a half. Slightly larger position here at the 21. And then finally in this zone in here, that's ideal. That's ideal. That's where if I were to get that opportunity, my largest position would be built in terms of sheer number of contracts. My largest position would be built down in that area inside the wave. Now, the other thing that I'm going to look at is the V-score. So let me just slide this up just a bit. And you'll notice that we've bounced off a slightly better than +2 standard deviation. So that's going to be your first level and probably one that will align well with this zone in here. But if we get a +1 standard deviation reversion, right, I think we'll be easily between the 21 EMA and the 34. Now here's the bottom line and the toughest part of being a trader. Nobody knows what's going to happen, but we know the probabilities are for continuation because, well, we learned this from physics. A body in motion tends to stay in motion. You know, let's keep it that simple. And so if I can get a reversion to a +2 standard deviation or a +1, that's definitely a buying opportunity. Let's see if that lines up with any of those three levels that I've mentioned. Now, is the same kind of opportunity going to arise in beans? I think it's starting to get better. It's starting to get interesting as November beans is kind of doing battle with the 200 EMA. No technical analysis tool is as important as the 200. Now, hold on for one second. I'm not saying it's the most significant in terms of setups and the most accurate, nothing like that. Accuracy, whatnot. What I'm saying is it's important because even traders who wouldn't even consider themselves chartists or technicians magically always know where that 200 is at, when there's a golden cross, when there's a death cross. That 200 is always in play. It transcends technical analysis and is probably the best example of the power of self-fulfilling prophecy that is an element of technical analysis. Now, technicians tend to get really upset with me when I say that, but part of technical analysis is the really simple stuff that's easy to plot Think pivots, think 200 EMAs or SMAs. Same thing with the 50. They typically have a more consistent reaction to them. So if we can get above the 200 in a more convincing manner, I'll be much more bullish. And then I wouldn't mind a correction or a reversion to a negative one standard deviation or maybe even just below that. Now, in the meanwhile, if we go here first, it is a buy, but I'd love to see this, this, and then a continuation. If I can dictate what I'd like to see, that would be ideal. Do I want to be long beans? Yes. Do I want to be long corn? Absolutely. At the top of the range? No way. Let's wait for that correction and we'll get our opportunity in that. I'll see you in the next update.